Friends, my name is Akash Kumar. I am from IIIT NR. My branch is EC and my roll number is 1510105.
I am Prakash Kumar, pursuing BTech from IIIT NR in branch Computer Science.
And myself Naveen Bhagat, and my branch name is CSC and my roll number is 90. Thank you.
Hello friends, I am Aswari Kumar Sahu from ECE branch in IIIT NR Raipur. Friends, we are working on a project named Smart Car Parking System. We have worked on that, and what the Smart Car Parking System is, let's see.
Here is a close look of what we have done in last few months. Friends, here is a wheel and Arduino UNO, motor driver, many breadboard, IR sensors and chassis, caster and 100 RPM to DC motors.
These are the two light sensors. Two IR sensors have two LEDs, light sensor. One is the transmitter and other is the RX light sensor. And the input of the light sensor is a Arduino digital input. And the light sensor follow the one.
As my friend has previously guided you, these are IR sensor. And here is one ground pin. Then two analog signals input and one is a output signal in both the IR sensors. And here is a motor, a DC motor, 100 RPM DC motor, which is responsible for the forward as well as backward movement of that chassis. And here is a Arduino UNO, the main heart of the body. And here is a motor driver which controls the movement. And here is a mini breadboard. Some feature of this IR sensor is that it only detects white light, a white color or white light, something like that. But it doesn't detect black, or it only detects white. Otherwise, it gives output as a 0. And if it detects white, then it gives input as 1. So the features of IR sensor is that it can detect white light. So it can detect fire, it can detect white LEDs or white color LEDs or bright light, and it can be used in fire also, but we are using in white in line follower techniques. So here is the principle of that it when it detects a white light on the in that paper, then it gives input as a 1, and that input is that output is taken as input for the Arduino UNO. Arduino UNO has designed such that when input 1 is coming on pin number 6 on Arduino UNO, then it detected as 1, and we have made commands such that suitable command for the purpose. And second, when this IR sensor gives same function that other IR sensor also, and after that we are compiling that program through Arduino UNO software. Now coming to motor driver actually gives input 1 or 0 according to what that input which we have given on motor driver. So here is a left motor which is connected here, left motor positive negative and right motor positive negative, and the motor driver takes input from that Arduino UNO plus 5 volt. The railing is the right railing is for plus volt and the left railing is for ground volt, and the plus 5 is divided into one IR sensor, second IR sensor, and third it is given input for the motor driver, and also ground are also divided accordingly. The 5 volt when input is given, then that pin M2A, M2B, M1A, M2, M1B here when one input is given from one input received here, then it rotate right. When one input is given on M1B, then it rotate left. When one input is given on M2A, then it rotate right. When one input is given on M2B, then it rotate left. According to that, it functions. It function and help in movement of forward or to turn right or left.
The command I have already put in the Arduino, and the light sensor input are in the Arduino in the digital, and the output of the Arduino in the motor driver input, and the input of the motor 1 and motor 2 go to the DC motor, and the DC motor follow according to the light sensor, Arduino and DC motor driver.
Friends, now you are familiar with this device. What are the inside story of the device? You have already informed with by my friends, and now you can see it working. Let's see. I am giving a power supply via power bank to this device. This is following the black line. You are watching this. There might be some problem. IR sensor is not that much better. So you can see it working properly. It is following the black path, as we have told you. Watch that. When this IR sensor is in black line, when this IR sensor is in black line, it sends the message to the Arduino board. Arduino board send message to the motor driver, and motor driver then send message to the motor here, yellow color device, and that motor is responsible for movement of wheels either backward or forward. If this IR sensor crosses crosses the border of white and black line, this IR sensor send message to the Arduino. Let's see. And Arduino is having command that this wheel is going in this wheel is moved in forward. This program is stored in the Arduino board. Here the L motor F means left motor forward. This happens, left motor go forward for output given high from the pin 9. L motor backward, forward and backward. So this is all done by the Arduino. Now our device is this. This is IR sensor, both the IR sensors and wheels. If the path is forward, then both IR sensor are on the white line. White. This means both the wheels go forward. We are programmed the command. We have given the command in the Arduino board such that if both the IR sensors are on white, then both the wheels move forward in this direction. Forward. When the path is like that, then IR sensor is on first on the black line. So IR, we have command such that this wheel reverse back and this wheel go forward. This when this happens, we are the device will move automatically in the right direction as we have our path designed. If this is in left direction, IR1 sensor is in black line, and hence the left motor will in backward mode and right motor will go forward. This helps the device to rotate left side.